This is a Raspberry Pi starter box. In this video you will learn how to install the Noobs package installer to connect over SSH and VNC. But first, let's see what comes inside the box. This is a box containing a Raspberry Pi 2, an SD card of 8, 16 or 32 GB, a power supply of 2 amps, HDMI cable, a Ethernet Cat 6 cable, and a Raspberry Pi enclosure. With the Raspberry Pi 3 now on the market, the Pi 2 version comes as a bargain. Great value for the money and choice for starters. But let's look more closely at what you get from a box like this. 2 amps power supply, and a 220 volts adapter. Installation guide. Meters of Ethernet Cat 6 cable with RJ45 connectors. HDMI cable with 1.8 meters. And this should be the mini computer. An SD card adapter. And feet stickers. Safety instructions. And the Raspberry Pi 2 and box enclosure. With 4 USB 2.0 and 1 Ethernet port. Mini USB power connector, HDMI port, and a 3.5 stereo jack. And this is the SD card slot up to 32 GB. The 40-pin GPIO connector header extender. 2 wall mounts. And in the description below, you can also check the specs of this mini Pi. Now to make use of this mini computer, you must install the operating system. Go to raspberrypi.org to download and install our operating system. On download page, install the official supported operating system, or use Noobs, the easy installer for Raspbian. Go ahead and download Noobs. And after download, insert the micro SD card adapter in your computer, unzip the package files, and then paste all of them to the SD card of your Raspberry Pi. Paste all files inside the unzipped folder, not the folder itself, if not it will not work. Then, with all files in the micro SD card in your Raspberry Pi, plug a wired mouse or keyboard, the HDMI cable, and the micro USB power supply. Then, connect your Raspberry Pi into a monitor, and plug it to a power outlet. And you should see something like this. Now go ahead and select the installer. Click to install the operating system in your Pi, and wait 10 minutes approximately. Now if you don't have a monitor, or just need to access your Pi via SSH or VNC, watch this next video to learn how to install the Raspbian OS image in a micro SD card or pen drive. With the install successfully, continue to reinitiate the Raspberry Pi. And with the boot completed, you should see something like this. You have successfully installed the operating system. Now to access the Raspberry Pi via SSH. Or from VNC connection, you need to plug the Ethernet cable, or a Wi-Fi dongle compatible with your Raspberry Pi. And after an IP address has been assigned, take note of the same IP address. And then from another computer, we can access the Raspberry Pi via SSH, and then connect via a virtual network computing. From macOS, press Command K, or from the menu bar in Finder, enter on Go and then connect to server. To connect to your Pi from a different computer, type exactly the following URL command replacing with the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. Or from terminal, type the following command, replacing with the IP address of your Pi. When the connection works, you'll see a security authenticity warning. Type yes to continue. And you will be prompted for the password for the Pi login. on Raspbian and the default password is Raspberry. And you should now be able to see the Raspberry Pi prompt, which will be identical to the one found on the Raspberry Pi itself. Now to connect to a Pi over VNC using macOS. Sometimes it is not convenient to work directly on the Raspberry Pi. Maybe you would like to work on it from another computer by remote control. On your Pi, using a monitor or via SSH, install the tightvnc package. Next, run tightvnc server, which will prompt you to enter a password and an optional view-only password. Now start a VNC server from the terminal. This example starts a session on VNC, display 1 with full HD resolution. Now type and verify a password for you to remember. You can skip the view-only password. And now you are ready to install and run the VNC client in your computer. For this you can use a program called RealVNC, downloaded from the link in description below in this video. Download the package file and open it. During the setup you'll be offered a choice of installation type. You only need the VNC viewer on your Mac, not the server, so select custom and then uncheck VNC server. Click continue and go ahead with the rest of the installation. Once the installation is complete, open Finder, then from applications on the left, enter VNC into the search box and open it. Now you will need to enter the IP address of the Raspberry Pi, followed by the screen number. Click the connect button, and you'll be given an unencrypted connection warning. Generally speaking, this warning is only applicable if the connection between your Mac and the Pi is going over the internet. If you're using a local area network or a school network, then you can disregard this warning. Click continue and you'll be prompted for the password that was specified when you configured the VNC server on the Raspberry Pi earlier. You should then find yourself at the Raspberry Pi desktop. Now on Windows PC, you will need to download an SSH client. The most commonly used is called PuTTY, and can be downloaded from the link in the description below of this video. Look for PuTTY executable file for Windows on Intel x86. PuTTY doesn't have an installer package, it's just a .dart executable file. When you run PuTTY, you'll see the configuration screen. Type the IP address of the Pi into the host name field and click the open button. If you eventually see a message saying network error, connection timed out, it's likely that you've entered the wrong IP address for the Pi. When the connection works you'll see the security warning, safely ignore it and click the yes button. And now you log in with the same username and password you would use on the Pi itself. The default login for Raspbian is Pi, and the password Raspberry. And then you should have the Raspberry Pi prompt. Now to connect over VNC using Windows, you'll need to download and install a VNC client program. First you need to install the tightvnc package. On your Pi, using a monitor or over SSH, install the tightvnc package. Next, run tightvnc server, which will prompt you to enter a password, and an optional view-only password. Now start a VNC server from the terminal. This example starts a session on VNC, display 1 with full HD resolution. Now to connect over VNC you'll need to download and install a VNC client program. A commonly used one is tightvnc, which can be downloaded from tightvnc.com. Depending on which version of Windows you are using, download the 32 or 64-bit download. During installation, and since you only need the VNC client and not the server, go ahead and choose custom. Then, select tightvnc server, and choose entire feature will be unavailable. Click next, and click next again, then install. Once the installation is complete you should find tightvnc viewer under the start menu. When you run it, you'll be presented with this dialog. Now you will need to enter the IP address of the Raspberry Pi, followed by the screen number. Click connect and you'll be prompted for the password that was specified earlier. You should then find yourself at the Raspberry Pi desktop. Now if you forgot the VNC password you assigned earlier, use this command to reset and create new password. Now if you want to buy Raspberry Pi starter box, just follow the links in description below in this video to get more info. And again, thanks for watching, subscribe and I see you in the next videos. Cheers.